the insurrectionist proudly waving a Confederate flag in the Capitol. Nevertheless, despite the clear breakdowns at the Capitol, we must get to the bottom of why that very day it took the Defense Department so long to deploy the National Guard once the need for reinforcements became patently clear on every TV screen in America.
Who were actually in place at the time making the decisions. It's unclear when senior defense officials authorized the National Guard to deploy. The Defense Department's public timeline states that Army Secretary McCarthy directed the D.C. National Guard to mobilize at 3:04 p.m. But according to the timeline the National Guard provided to the committees and a briefing from Major General Walker, commanding general of the D.C. National Guard, the instruction to deploy didn't arrive until 5:08 p.m. We need to know why the Pentagon took so long to deploy the National Guard.
Was on January 6th to include the civilian agency we were supporting. The Secretary of the Army's January 5th letter to me withheld that authority for me to employ a quick reaction force. Additionally, the Secretary of the Army's memorandum to me required that a concept of operation be submitted to him before the employment of a quick reaction force. I found that requirement to be unusual, as was the requirement to seek approval. Chief Sun, his voice cracking with emotion, indicated that there was a dire emergency at the Capitol, and he requested the immediate assistance of as many available National Guardsmen that I could muster. Immediately after that 149 call, I alerted the U.S. Army senior leadership of the request. The approval for Chief Sun's request would eventually come from the Acting Secretary of Defense and be relayed to me by Army senior leaders at 5:08 p.m., about 3 hours and 19 minutes later, who are out there and need assistance. The Army senior leaders did not think that it looked good, it would be a good optic. They further stated that it could incite the crowd. So their best military advice would be to the Secretary of the Army, who could not get on the call. So we wanted the Secretary of the Army to join the call, but he was not available. We were told that he was with the Secretary of Defense and not available. But the Army senior leadership expressed to Chief Conte, Chief Sun, Dr. Mitchell, the deputy mayor, and others on the call that it would not be their best military advice to have uniformed guardsmen on the Capitol.
National Guard in particular.
So I just keep imagining the scene. The whole country, the whole world is seeing this on TV. You've got the police line breached at this moment. You have smashed windows. You have insurrectionists going through the police lines. You are on the phone. Everyone is seeing this on TV, and they're not immediately approving your request.
I'm sorry.